ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Delaware Stadium for tonight's NCAA Women's Lacrosse game between the LaSalle University of Sports and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Your 2016 team chooses to dedicate the season to our loved ones who are fighting or have fought cancer. Please take a moment to honor Donna Lovell's victory battle. Her story began in October of 2005, when at the age of 43, she discovered she had breast cancer. Her life turned upside down with two young daughters to care for and the uncertainty of her diagnosis. With the support of her husband, family, and friends, she battled through treatment. Donna is here with us today in the stands and wants to thank her daughter, senior captain Addie, and all of her teammates for making her our honorary captain. Join us in celebrating Donna's victory over 10 years later, cancer-free. UD Lacrosse battles on and off the field to help us to raise awareness and find a cure for cancer. And now for tonight's starting lineups. First, for the visiting explorers. At midfield, a sophomore from Delran, New Jersey, number 3, Rachel Seplow. At midfield, a senior from Medea, Pennsylvania, number 8, Carrie Udy. At attack, a senior from Westchester, Pennsylvania, number 11, Caitlin Fay. At defense, a sophomore from Reading, Pennsylvania, number 12, Haley Lester. At attack, a senior from Fawn Grove, Pennsylvania, number 24, Katie Fonte. At midfield, a freshman from Issaquah, Washington, number 25, Ashley Blanton. At attack, a junior from York, Pennsylvania, number 27, Allie Ildenfritz. At attack, a sophomore from Malvern, Pennsylvania, number 28, Brittany Edwards. In goal, a sophomore from Bel Air, Maryland, number 35, Lucy Lachlan. At defense, a junior from Malvern, Pennsylvania, number 37, Daniel Strang. And in midfield, a senior captain from Centerville, Maryland, number 5, Abby O'Donnell. And in midfield, a senior captain from Baskin Ridge, New Jersey, number 19, Allie Burnett.
Volunteer assistant coaches Chelsea Bay, and assistant coaches are Norma Durkin and Chelsea Marshall. And our head coach for the Explorers is Candace Spasso. And now, for your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. At attack, a senior from Camillus, New York, number 3, Shannon Hawley. At midfield, a sophomore from Bethel, New Jersey, number 4, Becky Gosler. At attack, a junior from Ellicott City, Maryland, number 5, Jamie Schwartz.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Hens All Access coverage of University of Delaware Women's Lacrosse. I'm Kyle Coulter, back up here in the press box on this chilly February evening as the PA announcers finishing up the starting lineups for the University of Delaware Women's Lacrosse. Just something noticed about the LaSalle Explorers, a bit of a young team, three players making their first starts against Temple, and also three freshmen seeing their first action. So a lot of new blood on the sideline for the Explorers, so we'll see how that plays out against a very, very experienced Delaware team. Only graduated, three or four seniors last year. So a very tight unit. They've been playing together for 4 years, especially the defense with two seniors and a junior. Also Taylor Carpentier making her third career start in goal for the Hens, and I believe she's really benefited from the senior leadership on defense. As Coley Ricky comes out, very cool the other night when her father was the honorary captain in the game honoring her grandmother. She opened the scoring just 36 seconds in, and Delaware never looked back. George Washington gave them a tough fight, but it was all Delaware in the second half, outscoring George Washington 9-2 in the last 30 minutes for that 17-7 victory. And now we will step aside for the playing of our national anthem. We'll be right back with the opening draw.
Thank you.
Fans, University of Delaware, where the NCAA has many traditions, but bad sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators isn't one of them. Please support the participants and officials with respect and in a positive manner. Inappropriate behavior will be round for the rules of Delaware University.
So we are just minutes away from the opening draw here in the second home game of Delaware season, looking to improve to 3-1. LaSalle looking for their first victory of the 2016 campaign. Delaware will be in their home grays and LaSalle in their away blues. We're still waiting to see which side each team will be taking. But while we're waiting for that, just remember that if you want to keep UD Athletics at the top of their game, contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund and support the 21 varsity sports at UD. All contributions go towards scholarships, facilities, and much more. Go to bluehens.com/UDAF. Also, recap and broadcast archive of this game will be available on our YouTube channel at UD Blue Hens. Finally, if you want to find out what our crew does behind the scenes to bring you these broadcasts and spotlights, follow at HensAllAccess on Twitter. We're pretty interesting. I would recommend it. And also stay connected with all Blue Hens sports on social media by following at UD Blue Hens on Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube, or liking University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens on Facebook. For women's lacrosse, their Twitter handle is at Delaware WLAX, and on Facebook it is University of Delaware Women's Lacrosse. LaSalle finished 8-8 last season, 4-4 in the A-10. They were picked to finish fifth in the preseason coaches poll. And the A-10 now with 10 teams. So that conference expanding. They just added VCU this season. So we still have a while to go before conference play starts up, but if you want to talk about tough conferences, the CAA, always a difficult conference. Right now, Drexel's 2-0, Elon's 3-0, Towson's 3-0, Delaware 2-1, and also James Madison you have down there 1-2. But each team is playing really tough competition. Just tomorrow, Drexel's taking on Princeton, and then Thursday, Elon's taking on Duke. So the CAA playing some tough opponents this season, and Delaware came down to it last season in the CAA tournament. Losing to JMU in the semifinal game, and then Hofstra and Towson, an epic overtime thriller. So you can never tell with this conference, and it'll be exciting when we get into conference play. Delaware will open their CAA schedule at Elon on April 8th, so we do have plenty of time to go. And that was the one thing Coach Linville was talking about before the game. She told me, I still don't believe, and the team doesn't believe, that we played our best game yet. We still have work to do, and the goal is just to get better in the month of February. And, they just lost their last game against Penn, but talking with some of the players, they really thought they played an excellent game. They got into a hole early, went down 3-0, but then rallied and ended up making it a two-goal game with 4 minutes left. But then Penn was able to shut the door. But at this point, Delaware still does have a couple more ranked opponents on their schedule. They travel to Stony Brook in mid-March, and then in the beginning of April, they take on Princeton at home. And I actually misspoke. Their first conference game will be at Towson on March 26th. So still about a month to go before that game. And not sure exactly what the holdup here is on the sideline. It looks like the referees are talking with the coaches. Maybe a discrepancy with a stick. That's the only thing I could think of that would keep this game from starting. But thank you for sticking with us. It looks like one of the referees is checking on a LaSalle Explorer stick over there on the left side. And you know, with the rain, water does some crazy stuff to the mesh, particularly with men's lacrosse, but with women's lacrosse as well. And with the cold as well, so I'm sure they just want to make sure everything is up to code, and then we'll get underway. So while we wait, let's take a look at the box score from last year's game between these two squads. Allie Ilgenfritz for LaSalle had herself a nice day. 3 goals, 1 assist. Also Katie Fonte with a goal. Caitlin Fay did not put in a point in that game. Lucy Lachlan came in and replaced Gabby Antonelli. She gave up 7 goals, made 3 saves. Delaware outshot LaSalle 40-12. And also Delaware narrowly winning the ground ball battle in that one. LaSalle committed quite a few fouls, particularly in the second half. 15 of them in this final 30 minutes. Draw controls, Delaware was pretty dominant in that regard as well, 21-10. But as we mentioned, Delaware losing Caitlin McCartney, who won the majority of those draw controls, excuse me. And for Delaware, from the returning players, Mackenzie Rafferty had herself a nice day. 3 goals. Jamie Schwartz with 4 goals and 1 assist. Shannon Hawley with 2 goals and 1 assist as well. Kara Tatellis had 2 goals. Casey Lyons with a relatively quiet day for her. 1 goal, 1 assist. And Becky Gosler with 1. And also Elise Andrews getting on the board there with 1 as well. And that was last season. Almost exactly a year to the day. Delaware putting up 24 goals en route to that victory. And it looks like we are finally ready to get underway here at University of Delaware Stadium. LaSalle has broken their huddle. Looks like they will be going left to right in the first half as, once again, in their road blues. Delaware about to break their huddle. Coach Linville giving some final words of direction. They'll be going right to left in their home grays. And we'll see who each team sends out to take their draws. It looks like for LaSalle, it will be Allie Burnett, the senior from Basking Ridge, New Jersey. And for Delaware, will be Mary Abrams. Becky Gosler on the near side. We mentioned in pregame how important it's going to be for her on the wing. She'll be matched up with number 8, Carrie Newby, senior from Media, Pennsylvania. And remember, Casey Lyons wearing number 2 this evening. And we are underway here from University of Delaware Stadium. The ball rolling towards Delaware's offensive end, and it's scooped up by Shannon Hawley. The draw control goes to Delaware. She's bumped into, and that'll be a foul early there against the Explorers. Quick restart. Hawley spins out of it and then goes back. Erin Ween's able to loft it up to Kirsten Hale, coming off her first career hat trick, and she will get it into the offensive end, and Delaware will get the first crack on offense. Tatellis has it back now, dodges to her right. Now takes it behind to Lyons. Lyons drops it. Take a picture of that, because you won't see that very often. Delaware, very, very fundamentally sound, so that's a rarity right there. LaSalle, a gift. As mentioned, LaSalle had a tough time in their opener clearing the ball, so we'll see if they have any better luck this afternoon. Here's Leister taking it across the field. And that's the keeper, Lachlan, behind the cage, being guarded by Jamie Schwartz. Schwartz almost gets it out of her stick. Lachlan trying to find somewhere to go with it. Delaware on a man-to-man ride. Forcing the ball into the corner. There's Seplo. Seplo trying to use her speed, and she is ridden out of bounds. And they're going to get a call there against Delaware, it looks like. And the two of the three referees are going to confer. It looks like they're counting the number of Blue Hens on the offensive end. And they're getting everyone out of the box. So still Explorers ball here on the near side. It'll be Seplo, surrounded by 4 Blue Hens. The Explorers still looking to explore into the offensive end. Seplo fakes the pass. Spins out of a ride there by Gosler. Takes it over the midfield line. It's checked out from behind. Ball's down. Allie Karwoski going for the ground ball. And she earns the foul. And Delaware will get the ball back. So the clearing woes continue early here for the Explorers. Karwoski ready to restart. Lofts it back to Erin Ween, who's had the scoring bug early this season. 2 goals and 1 assist. She's recorded a point in each game. Coming out of the back end. Now Gosler has it. Gosler down low to Lyons. Lyons quick inside to Ricky, who could not pull in the rocket pass, but he's able to get the ground ball back, and Delaware can slow it down. Vitalis now with it up top. Gets to the near side for Hawley. Now at X, coming across goal line, extended is Lyons. Lyons looking to feed. Flips it back to Hawley. Hawley has some room in the middle of the field, decides to go low. It's checked out of her stick and picked up there by Burnett. And it's going to be a call against Delaware, it looks like. So a cause turnover there from Burnett. 2 turnovers on 2 possessions for Delaware. Now Burnett passes it forward. Still hard on the ride are the Blue Hens. Karwoski with another cause turnover. She's trying to pick up the ground ball, but it rolls out of play. And the Explorers will get it back. It'll be Allie Ilgenfritz, the junior from York, Pennsylvania, who, as we mentioned, had 3 goals last season against Delaware. Now the Explorers get their first crack on offense. Here's Katie Fonte at X, being guarded by Mary Abram. Fonte gets it behind. Now a good look inside. It's knocked down there by Carpentier. Good job there by the keeper. Snuffed out the pass and knocked it down. It's not the prettiest of starts. We get another turnover here. Fonte getting pushed out of the 8-meter. Good thing Abby Webble was there on defense, so that would have been a good look at goal for the Explorers. So 3 turnovers for Delaware already, 2 for the Explorers. And we are only 4 minutes in. Seplo has a lot of room to her right. She's going to dodge. Now spins back. Good defense there by Kirsten Hale. Into the 8-meter. Seplo backs it out. Explorers with 1 on the crease. Looking to feed inside. Now the ball goes behind. Attacking to the left is Fonte. Looks inside. The ball is knocked down and picked up. I believe that's Coley Ricky there on the ground ball. She lofts into the middle. Mary Abram looking for somewhere to go with it. Turns back, gains some separation. Now lofts it towards the midfield line. And now a look inside to Gosler. It goes past 2 sticks and ends up back in the stick of Ashley Blanton. Next time Delaware gets in the offensive zone, we might see a timeout. And now we get a stoppage of play. Quick restart there for the Explorers. Good run, but it's knocked out of the stick of Ilgenfritz. The junior has it just outside the 12-meter, and the referee imploring her to back up. Now on the restart. Ilgenfritz spins back to her left, trying to gain some separation. She's double-teamed. The ball is turned over. And almost given away again. Allie Karwoski with another cause turnover. Erin Ween is there. Now Ween gets it back. Up to Coley Ricky here on the near side. Pass up to Kara Tellis, who drops it out of her stick. And then she gets bumped to the ground hard. So some physical play already between these two teams. And a multitude of turnovers. Hawley to Jamie Schwartz. Guarded by Haley Leister. Gets it up top to Hawley. Back on the right side now. To Tellis. Lefty pass down low to Lyons. Looking inside. Good find. Schwartz. And she shoots it over the top of the cage. Another uncharacteristic play. Jamie Schwartz has taken 11 shots. She scored 7 of them this season. So you expect her to put that one in the back net. A good find there by Lyons. Delaware with the backup. It was a good hustle by Lyons and Schwartz once the ball went over the net to keep the ball in their possession. Detellis spins back right, has some separation, looking inside, now gets it back up top. It'll be Holly. Quick move to her right. Shot! That one goes wide. It might have been a pass to Schwartz, and now the play on was called. The play was stopped. It looks like it'll be Shannon Holly getting a free shot. Delaware was 0 for 3 against Penn from this position. And there is one LaSalle defender down low ready to come out and stop Holly. But Holly, a very talented shooter, particularly from the right side. And here we go. She's in. Fakes the shot. Good defense there by the Explorers to stop that break. That was Carrie Newby coming in and stopping the momentum. Here's Kara Detellis. Thought about going back to her right. Now Lyons wide open. Shot and a goal. Casey Lyons gets things going. And Delaware now up 1-0. Not sure how Lyons got so wide open. We'll take another look at it here. And just a miscommunication there on the defensive end by the Explorers. Good find by Detellis. She now has 4 assists in the last 2 games. And Lyons goes top right. Delaware with a 1-0 lead. Detellis now leads the team in assists with 6. Now we're back for the draw. It'll be Burnett and Abram yet again. The referee is still talking there on the far side. Casey Lyons with her 8th goal of the season. She now has 13 points. As Delaware makes some substitutions, taking advantage of this time. Abram is going to go over to one of her coaches. And get some last second pointers. And now the one referee going over and talking, asking both coaches to come to the 50-yard line. Once again, not 100% sure what this is about. I'm not sure if it's a discrepancy regarding the goal. It is not a warm evening out there. And I'm sure all the athletes looking to get their legs warm. Abram went over and talked to Gosler as well as Burnett went over to talk to Seplo. Communication between the wing player and the person taking the draw control is so crucial. As it is in men's lacrosse as well. So as we have a little bit more time, Delaware, this Saturday, we'll head to Rutgers for a 1 p.m. start, and they're back home to take on Canisius, Villanova, and Monmouth, March 5th, March 9th, and March 12th. Then they head on a 3-game road trip. And then the men's lacrosse team started off their season 0-3, but a promising performance this weekend against Navy, one of the top teams in the country perennially. They held the midshipmen to 3 goals until they had to pull their goalie, and then Navy put in 2 more and ended up winning the game 5-1. Trooper Ortlieb had the only goal for Delaware, but with a lot of questions surrounding the defense, it's a very impressive performance. They went down to Annapolis to play that game. Beautiful, beautiful area of the country. And the attack for Delaware looking to get their legs moving however they can. They're dancing to the songs on the PA. And all of the all the players getting a chance to know each other a little better out there. And we're going to step aside for just a moment, going to try to figure out what's going on down there so I can get to you some more information. I'll be right back. We are back here on Hens All Access. Sorry about the delay. If it makes you feel any better, none of the fine people up here in the press box knew what was going on either. I thought I might have seen a yellow card come out when one of the referees was talking to both coaches there on the sideline for quite some time. But we will get an official word from the field coordinator and see if we can sort this out. Meantime, all the a dance party still going on here on Tubby Raven Field. I don't know if you can see it on your side of the screen, but the attack for Delaware having a bit of a dance off there. Coley Rickey busting a move. Taylor Carpentier has dropped her stick and is trying to keep her hands warm. And now the referee has gone back over and is once again talking with both coaches. The clock still stagnant at 23-12. And the goal put in by Casey Lyons, which seems like forever ago, was the first goal of the game. It is now 1-0. As now you see the camera working in on the conversation. It may be discussing the Republican debate. Maybe it's getting political over there and they're trying to, and it's getting kind of heated. I'm not sure. Okay, so some new developments here, ladies and gentlemen. Apparently there was some kind of issue with Casey Lyons wearing number 2 instead of number 37, which is her normal number. She's listed as number 2. She's wearing number 2 this evening. And you see the replay of the goal there. It has since been taken off the scoreboard. So it looks like the goal is waved off. It is still 0-0, but Casey Lyons still wearing number 2. This is the information we've gotten from the sideline. And now the ball will end up in Lachlan's stick. And after what must have been 5 to 10 minutes of discussion, we are ready to get back underway. With the game tied 0-0 and LaSalle looking to clear. What a turn of events. A wacky start to this this one here at University of Delaware Stadium. So running up the near side is Newby, taking it over the midfield line. Looking to clear it, she does. Gets into Burnett. The ball drops, but a foul call there against Delaware. Well, Explorers still with it. Here's Edwards. Gets it behind. Dodge topside on Abram. Coming across goal line extended. Now working the ball back up top. That's Caitlin Fay. First time we've called her name this evening. Fay working her way into the 8-meter. And that's a nice look back. Drew the double team. Gets inside. Shot, and that one's saved. Fay. Good awareness there. Knew she drew the double team and tossed it back to Ilgen Fritz, who looks like will now get a free position shot from the 8-meter. Here we go. Ilgen Fritz in. Takes the shot, and it's in. Now the scoring begins. After a goal for Delaware was wiped off just a minute and 10 seconds later, Ilgen Fritz earns an eight-meter free shot and comes down and buries it. So the Explorers now up 1-0. We just saw it there again. And my, what a bizarre first 8 minutes of this ball game. We will head back to the draw control area where it'll be Abram and Burnett again. And what gets me is that Lions' goal was wiped off, but she's still wearing the number 2 jersey. But anyway, the Explorers up 1-0. We are back for the draw control. Burnett, Abram. It's lofted towards Becky Gosler. Able to knock it her way, and it ends up back in the stick of Abram. Abram, cradling with one hand, gets into the offensive end, avoids a dodge. Now she's in. Chance to tie it up here. Good look down low. That's Jamie Schwartz with the shot. It goes high. Lions has it back. Lions getting topside. Looking to spin in. Tries to loft it into Ricky, but it's knocked down. Good defense once again there by the Explorers. Now Holly has it up top. Gets to the Tellus. Ricky clears out the left side. The Tellus drives. Shields her stick well. Goes for the shot, and it's knocked down before it can reach the cage. And now we have an Explorer down. I believe she got hit with the shot coming across. And there was a stoppage of play before the shot, it looks like. And now the defender is up. That is Abby O'Donnell. So I believe it will be a foul on Kara De Tellus. I'm not exactly sure why she was the one taking the shot, and the referee is once again conferring as we just had another controversy. Now let's see the replay here. Detellus to her right. She lets a stick with her right hand and then goes for the shot. And she is issued the yellow card. So Delaware will be man down for 2 minutes. But it looks like Delaware will maintain possession. Becky Gosler has it outside the 12-meter. And we will get underway. Delaware one man down. Gosa brings it in. I'd like to just clarify earlier, the roster that we have here on the game program is not official. So the number being changed, I guess technically was an illegal substitution for Casey Lyons. Therefore, the goal would not count. But now that since that infraction was penalized, taking the goal off the board, Casey Lyons can stay in the game now as number 2. So. Bizarre start, and now Delaware a man down. Jamie Schwartz is looking to run out the penalty. We've got 30 seconds gone by. LaSalle electing to double team. which I personally have never been a fan of. Kirsten Hale has it outside. Coming towards the near sideline. Runs away from the double team, now gets it up top. Shannon Hawley able to corral that one in. Delaware just playing outside, well outside of the 12-meter arc, just trying to run down this penalty. We're under a minute. Gosler. Gosler shielding herself from Seplo. Delaware keeping it up top. Kirsten Hale with it now, and it's checked from behind, but we're going to get a call there against LaSalle. So Kirsten Hale sprints in. Spins back to her left, and this is where the conditioning comes into play. Hale. Still with it now, literally running in circles. Gosler up top. 30 seconds left on the penalty. Coley Rickey. Junior captain with a lot of quickness. Gets it down low to Lyons, and certainly a stick you would want the ball in to guard for 15 seconds. Lyons spins out. 10 seconds left in the penalty. Guarded by O'Donnell. And the penalty is released. Really nice job there by the Blue Hens. And now we're going to get a checkup around the head from Blanton, and that will be a yellow card for the Explorers. She runs right off. She knew it immediately. So now Delaware, after killing a two-minute penalty, they will now be up for 2 minutes. We've already seen a goal wiped off, a yellow card on an offensive player, and then immediately another foul on a defensive player. So find me a wackier 10 minutes and 44 seconds of lacrosse. Now the ref's talking once again. Can we please cue the Jeopardy music? The refs break their fourth powwow of the game. And Delaware will be man up for 2 minutes, trying to tie this game up at one. Hawley has it. Gets it up top to Kirsten Hale. Kara Detellis now with it, with a lot of room. Sprints into the 8-meter. Good recovery. Look inside. Rickey gets triple teamed. Goes behind the back for the pass. And we're going to get a free shot there for Coley Rickey. The ball ended up in the stick of Gosler. But the call was made already, so Rickey will have a chance to tie this game up at one. Free position shot with a man up. Golden opportunity here. Rickey sprints in, takes a shot, it's saved, and goes out of play behind. I believe Lachlan got a piece of that one. 1 minute, 35 seconds remaining in the penalty. Lyons has it behind. Dance at the goal line extended, looks inside. Gosler has it now, spins, triple team, spins again, gets it knocked out of her stick, and we'll see if that was inside the 8-meter or not. It looks like we're going to get another card against the Explorers. This one on number 8, Carrie Newby. So we've mentioned that these two teams are not too fond of each other, and we've seen three penalties in the first 11 minutes and 20 seconds. So now Gosler with an opportunity now. Gets it behind. Lyons, Delaware, two men up. Detellis gets it over to Hawley. Hawley sprints in. Lefty shot and a goal. And that was actually Kirsten Hale put it in. Should have noticed with a stick in her left hand. She now has 4 goals in the last 2 games. And Delaware has tied it up at 1 courtesy of 2 penalties from the Explorers. Those penalties will be wiped off, and both teams will be back at even strength. We see it again there. So tough in lacrosse, being 2 men down to guard against the goal. And Delaware able to take advantage. And now Delaware finally officially on the board. Score 1-1. 8 minutes and 31 seconds left in a first half that has taken very long. So Burnett and Abram back to take the draw. As mentioned, both penalties wiped off. And now one of the referees is on the sideline again. And it looks like one of the penalties will remain on the board. Carrie Newby, the penalty being a more serious infraction, does not get released after the goal. So the draw is won by Kara Detellis in Delaware, who is still a man up. Good look to Becky Gosler. Gosler, 12-meter, 8-meter, past the Lions. Lions fake shot and a goal. This time it counts. A beautiful play there from the Delaware offense. Gosler to Lions. Lions to the back of the net. It was a great find from Kara Detellis to start it off. And here we see it. Gosler draws the defender, goes to Lions. Lions fakes high, shoots low. And we have ourselves a 2-1 game. And now just about 20 seconds later, Abram back. And now we're going to get a timeout, it looks like, here from the Explorers. So in a first half with more stops than traffic on 95. Delaware with a 2-1 lead. 18 minutes and 18 seconds remaining. We take a look there at the Kirsten Hale goal. And now here with the Gosler goal once again, or the Lions goal, excuse me, Gosler with the assist. So now Lions has 8 goals on the season. Gosler, that was her first assist of the 2016 campaign. And having not gotten some action in a while, one of the coaches out working out Carpentier, rifling bounce shots. Looks like the Explorers ready to break their huddle. Once again, you are watching Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware women's lacrosse. I'm Kyle Coulter. Here on a chilly and rainy night in Newark, Delaware. And just from the start of it, doesn't look like we'll see another epic offensive performance from Delaware. As we mentioned, the last two meetings between these two teams, Delaware's put up a combined 42 goals. 18 in 2014 here, setting a University of Delaware Stadium record, and 24 last season at LaSalle. So Abram and Burnett back again. The ball is up, rolls to the near side where Gosler's able to pick it up. Splits three defenders, gets it over the midfield line and lofts it forward. Delaware looking to add another one. Coley Rickey into the 12-meter, wisely decides to back it out. Now Lions has some room. Fakes a shot and then goes low from very low angle. Lions, number two for number two. And Delaware now has a 3-1 lead. Those two goals coming in a matter of seconds as we see Lions fake the shot originally, then goes 5-hole on Lachlan. And it is now 3-1 Delaware. Lions maybe with a little chip on her shoulder after her first goal was disallowed. Coley Rickey getting the assist on that one. That will be her first assist of the season. Abram and Burnett back again. All four wing players on the near side. That one's lofted high into the air. Ball still bouncing around in the circle, and Coley Rickey will come up with it. Hawley, check up high. Delaware will get the ball back at about the 28-yard line. Hawley sprints in, and then goes far side for Schwartz. Schwartz still with it. Gets it up top to Detellis. Detellis crosses back over to her right, looking to feed. Now gets it back up top. Hawley to attack. Goes to her right, strong defense. Now gets it behind. Jamie Schwartz looking inside. Gets it up top to Detellis. Once again, good off-ball defense from the Explorers. Detellis is inside. Play on. Shot, and it's in. But it looks like they were going to bring it back. And Detellis will get a free shot from the 8-meter. And she will have a clear shot into the cage. Burnett, the closest defender. Detellis had two free position shot goals against George Washington here at home. Detellis with low angle. Shot, save! By Lachlan, she read her scouting report. Detellis favors that low bounce shot. Lachlan was right there. So good defensive stand by the Explorers, who now trying to clear. And there's a drop. Rickey picks up the ground ball. It's going to be a fast break. Hale, 12-meter, 8-meter, fakes a shot to her left. Shot, and that one goes just wide. Jamie Schwartz there on the backup. Intelligent play by Hale. She knew if she was going to miss, miss high or wide. Don't let it be a save, and that one is high over the stick of Shannon Hawley, but she's able to get it back. Rickey has it up top now. Directing traffic. Looking for Kirsten Hale to come up and maybe get a dodge. Hale goes far side. Hawley spins back left. Hale has it up top now. Going to clear out the right side. Good defense there by Leister. Detellis attacking the left side. Works back right. Now up top. Kirsten Hale has it once again. Under 16 minutes to go here in the first half. Detellis into the 8-meter. Looks inside. Good find. And off the crossbar is Coley Rickey. A good look inside. And a nice turn and fire. But just 2 inches away. Walkland has it now. Delaware once again in a man-to-man ride. And that ball is wide, and it'll go out of play. Good ride again for the Blue Hens. And now we get a stoppage of play. The referee resetting some of the players on the far side of the field. Detellis leaves it back for Lions. Lions attacking from up top now. Tries to sprint in. Draws a double team. Looks inside. The pass is not handled there in the crease area. Ends up in the stick of Blanton. Blanton still with it. Passes it back. Lachlan with it now. LaSalle currently 2 of 5 on their clears. Sprinting out of the back end now is Newby. Newby, using her speed, takes it over the midfield line. First time LaSalle's been in the offensive end in a while. Newby still with it. Has some room. Gets into the 8-meter, trying to go coast to coast. And she's finally swallowed up by 3 Delaware defenders. Get a bit of a yard sale there on Kirsten Hale check. LaSalle maintains possession. And they'll look to cut into this Delaware lead with just over 14 minutes left to go in the first half. Ball is worked behind. Here's Ilgen Fritz to the near side for Seplo. LaSalle in a wide open set. Fonte works it behind to Edwards. Seplo has it again. Now LaSalle will set up their offense, looking for off-ball picks inside. Edwards drives on Abram. Now gets it up top. Nogan Fritz looking back for the offensive set. It's to Seplo. Seplo looks to dodge. Nowhere to go. Looks down low. Long offensive possession now for the Explorers. Trying to get a look inside. Fay has it now. Nogan Fritz with Seplo clearing out the right side. Hale forcing back into the inside. Double team comes. Leaves it back for Fay. Fay rolls to her right. Now gets it back up top. Good defensive stand here by Delaware. Nogan Fritz gets it behind. Trying to find anything in the crease area that LaSalle can work with. And it's just good off-ball defense. Seplo gets it up top. Ilgen Fritz. There's Fay working from behind. Scored two unassisted goals in the opener against Temple. Spins back inside. Looks for the shot. That one's stuffed by Carpentier. It was a fantastic job by Abby Webble forcing Faye to turn back. And it looked like her and Carpentier have been working together for years. Knew exactly where Webble was pushing her. Came out and stuffed the shot. Now Delaware has it back after a long LaSalle offensive possession. Hale looking to penetrate a little bit. But Newby is there. To tell us. And that one is lost there by Holly as it's rolling towards the sideline. Holly able to one-hand scoop it and keep it and barely keeps it in bounds. Some very uncharacteristic play here from Delaware. Usually so fundamentally sound. Patelis trying to look backside. Double team has come. There's got to be someone open. And LaSalle able to recover. Here's Holly sprinting on the far side so fast, but the ball is lost. Ilgen Fritz with a nice defensive stand. Running for the ground ball is O'Donnell. She gets it and lofts it back to Lachlan. Lachlan still with it now. Gets it to the near side for Strang. Strang looking to sprint up the middle. And she does. Gets it over the midfield line. Hounded by Kara Tatelis. Tatelis with the check and the cause turnover. Got just enough of the stick. Now Mackenzie Rafferty with it. Bouncing like a pinball, keeping it in her stick, and a long pass up to Erin Ween, who suddenly found herself at attack. Ween sprinting in. She's got two goals on the season, looking for three. The shot, she's knocked down in the 8 meter, and looks like she will get a free position shot. Ween went down hard. Looks like she's holding a leg. Went down hard to the turf, which I can't imagine is too forgiving right now. Looks like she's up and ready to take her well-earned free shot. From way up top, she's got two attackmen lurking at goal line extended that she could pass to or sprint in and shoot it herself. And she goes down low to Schwartz. Schwartz with a shot, and it's in! Beautiful unselfish play there by Ween. Picks up her second assist of the season, and Schwartz buries it for her eighth goal of the season. Delaware now up 4-1. So Delaware capitalizing on unsettled play in the first half. Ween quickly down to Schwartz. Schwartz gets a little shoulder fake and then drops it in. Textbook there from the Blue Hens, and Delaware now with a 4-1 lead. Schwartz now has, dating back to last season, has scored a goal in 9 straight games and has scored a point in 11 straight games. And Erin Ween, building a little point streak of her own, now has a point in 4 consecutive games. Uncharacteristic of a defender. Abram Burnett back to take the draw. Gosler and Seplo on the near side. That one's popped straight up. And sprinting out of the front end is Coley Rickey. come and get that draw control. We mentioned this would be a crucial aspect of this game, draw controls, and Delaware has won all six. Schwartz able to corral that one in. Takes it behind to X. Vitellis coming off a couple screens. And now Ricky looking inside. Schwartz unable to get it into her. Good defense again there by O'Donnell. The senior captain, Mackenzie Rafferty. Scored 3 goals against LaSalle last season. Gets it to Holly. Holly splits to her right. Looks backside. Schwartz now has it at X. Lofts it up top. And Vitellis will reattack the left side. The slide is waiting. Draws the double team. Works it behind. Schwartz now looking inside. Good offensive movement, better off-ball defense there from the Explorers. Schwartz from goal line extended. Still looking to feed. Now gets it up to Holly for a dodge. Holly stutter steps to her right, spins back left, gets it up top to Rafferty. Rafferty to Detellis. Detellis bodying her way in, now gets it back behind to Schwartz. Rafferty, inside look, it was there. But a little bit of congestion there in the 8-meter. The Blue Hens not sure which one was going to pick it up. So the ball goes past, and it ends up back with the Explorers. Edwards has it, the 35-yard line. With 3 Blue Hens around her. Edwards still going in a high check there by Hale. Quick restart. And now the referee telling Hale to get back a few yards. Burnett. Long pass ahead, and it's knocked out of the stick by Webel. Another cause turnover for Delaware's defense, and Detellis with the ground ball. Gosler. Backs out. Still trying to get over the midfield line, and she does. Abby Webel. Holly. And now Detellis will have it. Delaware with the ball again with under 8 minutes to go in the first half, up 4-1. Detellis looks down low to Schwartz. Schwartz guarded by O'Donnell. Now up top, Holly to attack. Blows past the defender and gets it behind. And we're going to get a call there against the Explorers. And it looks like Holly will get a free position shot from the far hash. We see checked into the game Anna Gordon, the junior from Linwood, New Jersey. So a lot of congestion in the middle there for the Explorers. So it doesn't look like Holly will have a look at Cage. And now Gosler goes into the 8-meter. Holly looks up top. Ricky. Now Detellis has it. Splits to her right. Now back to her left. And we're going to get another infraction there against the Explorers. And Detellis has earned another free shot. But once again, 2 defenders lurking there. Right to her left. Becky Gosler is open on the far side of the 8-meter because the defender will have to go back and guard Jamie Schwartz, but Detellis decides to pull it out. Wise move there by the senior. Holly looks down low. Schwartz had some room, but Explorer is able to recover. Holly now with it up top. Ricky clears out the right side. Detellis again. Draws a double team, looks down low, nothing to get, nowhere to go. Splits 2 defenders, she's in. Gets it to Gosler, who drops the pass in the 8-meter. Ball still bouncing around. We'll see who can come with a ground ball. And I believe that's Detellis who went down there. She's able to bring herself back up. A lot of contact, going to be a lot of sore bodies tomorrow. It's a very physical first half. Mackenzie Rafferty gets it across to Ricky. Long offensive possession for Delaware. Schwartz with it behind. Now sprints back to her left, gets top side, looks inside, goes for a shot and a goal. Beautiful job there by Janie Schwartz getting the separation. And Gosler, exactly where she needed to be, followed the slide and dumped it in. Delaware now up 5-1. Gosler collecting her second point of the evening. We'll see it again there. You're taught when your defender is the slide to go help the other defender, you follow her. And that left Gosler wide open, 3 yards out, and she'll hit that one every time. Gosler now has 3 goals on the season, including the 1 assist she got earlier in the game. So 6 minutes and 5 seconds, Delaware with a nice long offensive possession. They're able to culminate that with a goal. So now 5 straight goals for Delaware. Looks like we'll get a change here at the draw control area for the Explorers. It is now Brittany Edwards, the sophomore, in to relieve Burnett. Abram and Gosler have been pretty dominant so far this evening at the draws. That one goes straight up. Abram knocks it Gosler's way, and Gosler picks it up. The two really on the same page so far in this one. Gosler ducks out of a check and gets it to Ricky. Delaware's already scored 2 goals right off the faceoff, the draw, excuse me. But this time the Explorer is able to recover. Rafferty gets it up top. A dodge from Holly on the right side. Goes back to her left. Draws a double team. Now gets it to Detellis. Detellis with a nice move. Righty shot. That one goes over the cage. Good look up top. Rafferty gets by one defender. Now two. She's into the 8-meter. Gets a check. Is able to pick the ball back up. Thought there could have been a call there, but the ref's letting them play here as we approach 5 minutes left in the first half. Holly with it up top. Looking for Schwartz to come out and help. Now Schwartz shakes and bakes to her right. O'Donnell's right there. Gets it up top. Holly sprinting by. Shot. That one saved. Good work there by Lachlan. After she faced 32 shots against Temple, no rest for the weary for her. She's made some really nice saves so far in this one. The Explorers trying to cut into this Delaware lead, but are having a really tough time getting the ball over the midfield line. Split back to the right. That's Newby. Newby sprinting into the offensive end, hounded by Abby Webble. And now Newby will back up. 3 gray shirts ahead of her. She'll do well to pull it out and wait for the offense to set up. That one's flipped to Edwards. Edwards still with an inner stick. Edwards looking inside, goes top side, spins back to her right, trying to free or stick up for a shot, but at very little angle. Edwards still with it. Now goes to Fay. Ricky has to come cross crease. That ball goes up top. Seplo has it. The goal scorer, Ilgen Fritz. Edwards with it again, looking inside. Now working top side, spinning back. Edwards trying to get into a shooting area. She's checked from behind. Ball's on the ground. And Faye's able to come up with it. Delaware's defense a little bit out of position, but they're able to recover. Ogun Fritz with a dodge, going right at the heart of the Delaware defense, trying to earn a free shot. And they're going to call it against the Explorers. Abby Webble is fired up, and as well she should be. On the game, honoring her mother. She's already come up with a few caused turnovers, and right there, sprinting up the field, impressive speed. Draws the foul, gets a check from behind. She'll get the ball back. It'll be 5-on-4 for Delaware, briefly. But Webble decides to get it up to Schwartz, and Delaware's offense will set up again with just over 2 minutes remaining in the first half.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
A couple fresh faces in for Delaware. We see number 11, Devin Heidelball, and number 8, Caroline Farley. Hawley to her right. Drops the ball. The ball is now bouncing around in the crease area. Goser looking to come up with it. It looks like that'll be O'Donnell, but she runs out of bounds before she's able to corral it. So Delaware will get the ball back. 1 minute and 32 seconds left in the half. Laughlin's going to have to sprint back into the cage. She's currently residing in the middle of the end zone. Goser lofts it up. And Hawley has it now. Being guarded tightly, LaSalle really pressing, trying not to give up another goal before the half. Hale. Farley. Now over to Hawley. Being shaded heavily to her left side. There by Ogun Fritz. Hale draws a double team, gets a check from behind. Great cause turnover there from the Explorers. And now heading over the full head of steam, that's Anna Kelly. Once again, the Explorers having a tough time clearing. Kelly finally hits the turf. But it's a call against Delaware. Kelly, the senior midfielder, causes the turnover, now lofts it into the middle of the field. That's Leister. Leister getting it up. 40 seconds now. That'll be Fonte behind. Gets it to Edwards. LaSalle will have last crack at it. 30 seconds to go before halftime. Trying to make this a 5-2 game. Edwards looking inside. Forces the pass. But luckily, it passes all Delaware sticks and ends up back with Edwards. Seven seconds now. Edwards working on Abram. 4 seconds now. She's just got to loft it in. Good defense by Abram. The shot, and it's saved. Great defensive stand to end the half for Delaware. A wild half of lacrosse here at the University of Delaware Stadium. Delaware with a 5-1 lead. Could have been 6, but if you joined us after the first 10 minutes, Casey Lyons put in a goal, but she's actually wearing number 2 this evening, and apparently there was some controversy with that. So it was deemed an illegal substitution, so her goal was wiped off. Then 10 seconds later, pretty much, or a minute and 10 seconds later, excuse me, LaSalle came down and got the first goal of the game. But since then, it's been all Blue Hens, as we see the second of Casey Lyons' 2 goals in that first half. Also scoring for the Hens, Jamie Schwartz with a goal and an assist, Kirsten Hale with a goal, Becky Gosler with a goal and an assist, and Coley Rickey and Aaron Weed adding assists as well. But Delaware dominant on the draw controls. They've gotten all 7. And once again, LaSalle's troubles clearing the ball have continued. They were 6 of 11 in that first half. And scratching their heads right now as to how to put the ball in the back of the net. The first game, Chelsea Fay put in both the goals in their 13-2 loss to Temple. Both of them were unassisted. And the one goal scored by Ogun Fritz was off a free position shot, so that one also unassisted. Delaware's defense looking sharp in the first half. We are just over 6 minutes away from the start of the second half, so don't go anywhere. I'll be right back with more lacrosse here on Hens All Access.
Blue Hens Women's Lacrosse will return to Delaware Stadium on Saturday, March 5th to host Kinesis at noon in a Blue Hens Lacrosse doubleheader. One $5 ticket is valid for both the noon women's game and the 3 p.m. men's game versus Villanova. In other UV Athletics news, Delaware men's basketball will take on Elon in its home finale this Saturday at 2 p.m. at the ball, while women's tennis will host Howard at the Elkton Indoor Tennis Courts at 6:30 p.m. Men's tennis will take on St. Joseph's on Sunday at the DuPont Country Club at 3 p.m. For details and to purchase tickets, visit bluehens.com.
Thank you.
So after a half that saw 26 combined fouls, 3 yellow cards, 7 combined goals, only 6 of which that counted, you can only imagine what the second half will have in store for us here at University of Delaware Stadium. I had that planned out. Can't believe I screwed it up. But anyway, welcome back into Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware Women's Lacrosse. I am Kyle Coulter. Delaware with a 5-1 lead over the visiting Explorers of LaSalle. They will be going left to right in the second half. LaSalle going right to left. Delaware dominant and the draw control is winning all 7. They've also had 12 shots on goal compared to LaSalle's 3. Or 12 shots compared to LaSalle's 3. 7 of Delaware's shots have been on goal. LaSalle actually winning the ground ball battle 8-7. But they have committed 14 fouls. Both teams with 10 turnovers, which is uncharacteristic for this Delaware squad and certainly not what Coach Linville was looking for. But can't argue with a 4-goal lead and holding your opponent to 1 goal. But we're back to take the draw control. It'll be Abram, and it looks like Edwards, the third Explorer, to take a draw in this game. Ball is up. Abram able to knock it to herself, trying to escape from the Explorers. And she's able to scoop it up and move it ahead. That's Hale sprinting in, 12-meter, 8-meter, on shot and a goal! Using pure speed, Kirsten Hale on her way to back-to-back hat trick. She has 2 this evening, and 15 seconds into the second half, Delaware on the board, now up 6-1. There was no stopping Kirsten Hale on that one. And I hope he didn't blink, because we're now back taking another draw control. Abram doing a phenomenal job. That one's tossed towards the sideline. And it is finally picked up and won by the Explorers, their first draw control of the evening. Ilgen Fritz now with it. Gets checked from behind, and they're going to get a call against Hale. Ilgen Fritz picks it up immediately and sprints in. Takes it behind to X, and now we're going to get another stoppage of play. And that will send, looks like, Coley Ricky out of the box. Edwards here on the near side. Now Seplo. We'll see what offensive changes were made. Seplo attacking, gets into the 8-meter. And we're going to have a call here against Delaware. And it was just... It will be a free position shot from the top side. Becky Goester is going to sprint in, and a false start there by LaSalle. Seplo a little eager to get in. And a wasted opportunity there for the Explorers. Erin Ween now has it. We know she can burn. Gets it over the midfield line. Gets checked from behind, and she's got to be tired of that. She made a run in the first half where she got checked from behind and then went down hard in the 8-meter. Was still able to get an assist. And the fourth card... The fourth card of the evening. Third for LaSalle. Delaware will be man up for 2 minutes. Holly with it. So an unfortunate turn of events there for the Explorers. They have a free position shot from the top of the 8-meter. And a false start wipes that away. And then almost immediately following, a foul. Holly goes to her right. Looks down low. Schwartz inside. Shot there from Hale. Looking for another hat trick. And a good job there from O'Donnell. to toss it back to Lachlan. Seplo with it now, looking to clear. Gets into the middle of the field. That's Leister sprinting up, protecting her stick well. Gets checked from behind by Holly, who kind of falls into her. And we'll see if, that was Lyons came crashing in. Now Edwards on the near side, splits the double team, takes to the center of the field, and the Explorers will set up the offense. Ilgen Fritz looking back to X. Now Faye takes it top side. Gets it up top, that's Burnett. Delaware still man up, electing not to double team, and now they're going to send Coley Ricky. ...43 seconds remaining on the penalty. Faye gets it up top. Edward has it now. Hilgen Fritz. Hale turns her back. That's Allie Karwoski. Explorers doing a good job killing this penalty. 20 seconds remaining before they're back at full strength. They have not scored since there was 22 minutes and 2 seconds left in the first half. After 93 minutes of play this season, they've only managed 3 goals. Currently find themselves down by 5. Penalty is released. Both teams back at even strength. Now the ball's up top. Ilgen Fritz. Karwoski turning her back inside. Now down low. Edwards has it. Edwards takes it behind to X. Abby Webble waiting at goal line extended. Another long possession for the Explorers. Ilgen Fritz splits to her right. Look inside, and that one goes all the way to the stick of Carpentier. Looks like we're going to get a foul there against Karwoski outside of the 8-meter. So Ilgen Fritz will get it. She decides to turn and run it back. Faye. Down low. Burnett looking inside. Delaware's defense once again up to the task. Seplo. Guarded by Aaron Ween. Ween takes the ball out of the stick, but they're going to say the check was a little high. So the Explorers will maintain possession. The ball was just outside the 8-meter. So no need for Delaware to clear out. Seplo has it now. 4 gray jerseys in front of her. She works it behind. Edwards. Burnett has it now. Seplo. Guarded by Detellis. Works to her right. Now gets it behind. And not a lot of off-ball movement here for these Explorers. They're trying to work it into the 8-meter, but having a real tough time getting it in. Burnett. Ilgen Fritz. Splits to her right. Karwoski is there again. Lofts it in. And Faye comes up with it. Shot, and it's in! A bit of a broken play, but it'll work anyway. Caitlin Faye knocks it in for her 3rd goal of the season. And the Explorers put one in here in the second half. And Faye, with 2 defenders and the keeper all over, still somehow able to get the ball into the net. So it is now 6-2. Ilgen Fritz with the assist. She now has 2 points on the season, all of them in this game. Both of them, I should say. So finally, a long offensive possession culminates in a goal for the Explorers. See if they can build on this momentum. It'll be Edwards and Abram back to take the draw. That ball slung back towards LaSalle's defensive side. And it's picked up. Another draw control here for the Explorers. Ilgen Fritz has it knocked out of her stick. Abram picked it up, but her foot was on the line. I believe that's actually Danielle Strang, right here on the near side, who has it. Gets into the middle. Faye gets checked from behind. And Gosler goes down. Turf Monster got her there. So a double team here on the near side. The ref's going to call Abby Webble for an illegal check. Anna Kelly is back in the game. Here's Seplo. Ilgen Fritz goes far side for Burnett. Kelly has it back. Attacks the right side. Webble is there. Ilgen Fritz looking to dodge. A lot of traffic in the middle. Decides to get it back out to Faye. Faye going to go to work. Spins inside. Keeps it with a left hand. Shot. That one goes right into the chest of Carpentier, who makes another save. Aaron Ween now has it with some room up ahead. A long pass up to Tatellis. Good find. It'll be a 5-on-4 with Hale joining the party. Tatellis looking inside. Finds Lyons. Lyons spins. Looks down low. There's a shot and a goal from Shannon Holly. Delaware on the fast breaks have been outstanding, not just in this game, but all season. From end to end, Hall and then Lyons, great job seeing the field. Holly had in her right hand and is able to drop it in. For Holly, that is her fifth goal of the season, and Delaware responds, going back up by 5. And that was just perfectly executed from Carpentier to Ween, Ween to Tellus to Lyons, Lyons down to Holly, and Holly to the back of the net. But Edwards has come in and done a nice job at the draw. She's won both that she's taken. That ball is tossed towards the near side. It's picked up again by the Explorers. That's Katie Fonte with it, getting double teamed here on the near side. Heidelball and Ween making life very difficult for the Explorers. Ball still bouncing around. Ween comes up with a ground ball. Ween puts it into second gear. Takes it in. Now splits to her right and she gets bounced out. We're going to get a foul. Another foul call against the Explorers. And they're going to say that Ween was inside the 8-meter. So she'll get another free position shot. It seems like every time she has a fast break, comes down and clears the ball, she makes something happen offensively. See what she decides to do with it here. Protects her stick. Shot! 5-hole and a goal! Erin Ween, her third of the season. She's got 2 points on the evening in Delaware. Now with a 6-goal lead. If you looked at her stat line, you would not think she was a defender. She's been reaping the benefits of great outlet passing. And she's been just using her athleticism, getting into the 8-meter and forcing the call. Forcing the ref's hand to some extent and get on the 8-meter and just doing damage. So now we're going to get a timeout from LaSalle. And with that, we will step aside for a brief moment. But don't go anywhere. I'll be right back with more lacrosse here on Hens All Access. Kyle Coulter back with you here at University of Delaware Stadium, where the Blue Hens have opened up their largest lead of the game. They are now up 6, courtesy of the goal from Aaron Ween, the senior, who has broken out offensively this season. 3 goals, 2 assists in 4 games. So now we're going back to the draw. It'll be Abram and Edwards again. The ball goes Delaware's offensive way, and it's scooped up by Coley Rickey. Spins out of 2 defenders, and Karwoski outlets. Now Webble has it coming out of her defensive position. Gets it up to Holly, and Delaware's offense will go back to work. Rickey goes past her stick, but she nudges it over to Holly. Will reattack the right side. Draws the slide. Now works it behind. There's Schwartz looking to feed. Now gets it up top to Tellis. Flirts with the 8-meter, but keeps it outside. Gets it up to Holly. Holly splits to her right. She's in. Shot and a goal. Bottom left. Shannon Holly with her 2nd of the day, vintage number 3, as she beats 2 defenders and goes bottom left. Delaware now up 9-2. A little Midnight City playing here at University of Delaware Stadium. Holly with her 6th goal of the season. Most of them looking just like that. And before this draw, let's go back to Aaron Ween real quick. She has started and played since her freshman year. She has played in 51 games in her career, and has only scored 2 goals. In 3 games this season, she has 3. So I guess she was a little tired of not scoring, not getting her name in the stat sheet, even though she has been an invaluable part of this team since she was a freshman. So a little infraction there on the draw, but Abram and Edwards ready to go back at it. That one's up in the air, rolling to the near side. And it is scooped up by the Explorers. And that's Kelly again. Who tried to start a fast break, but Delaware's defense able to recover. Double team comes. Kirsten Hale knocks the ball free, but call coming against number 12. So now good opportunity here from Kelly. Refs tell Devin Heideball to back up a couple steps. Kelly leaves it back for Seplo. Seplo, one more. That ball goes past Edwards. Now Webble has it. Gets it up to Ween, and if that pass had connected, it would have been trouble. Aaron Ween knocks the ball free, not once but twice against Seplo. It looks like Ween might have caught in a stick up around the ear. The call goes the Explorers' way, and that one goes over the stick of number 30, Nicole Black, the redshirt sophomore, who's checked in the game, trying to infuse some life into this offense. And the ball looks like it might have disappeared into the hedges here at University of Delaware Stadium, but Abram is able to find it. And Delaware has the ball again with just over 21 minutes to go in the second half. Abram takes it in the middle of the field, cradling with one hand, sprints over the midfield line, and gets it into the offensive end. Abram looked like she might have had eyes for goal there, but decided wisely and backed it out. Schwartz Delaware, no rush. Schwartz takes it over goal line, extended. Looking inside, nothing there. Now gets it up top. Vitellis dodges to her right. She's in. And she draws the foul in the 8-meter. It'll be another free shot for number 24. She will have the left side wide open to go right in on goal. Metellus decides to back it out. And now she gets it back. Attacking the right side. Takes it to X. Ball still in her stick in the right hand. Looking to feed inside. Defender goes down in the middle. Then we get a stoppage of play. I believe it's going to be against Delaware. And Gordon will get the ball. Looking to start a break. Gordon tosses it back. Now Lachlan has it. Lachlan goes near side for Leister. Leister guarded by Lyons. Leister using her speed. She gets checked and the ball's dropped. Ball knocked out. Lyons causing the ball to drop, but picked up by Kelly. Now Seplo having a tough time keeping it in her stick. Kelly gets it back. Kelly gets the ball checked out, but we're going to have a call there against Becky Gosler. Now Black has it. Gets it behind. That's Fonte. Now we have another stoppage of play with 19 minutes and 9 seconds to go. Looks like the referee counting Delaware defenders once again. And the Blue Hens pointing at Kara, that's telling, hey, Kara, to tell us she's back there. We have enough. We're good. That ball goes up top. Ilgen Fritz, who opened the scoring this evening for both teams, tries to spin inside, draws the slide. Fonte. Ilgen Fritz has it again. Now gets it behind. There's Faye looking to feed. Guarded by her numerical counterpart, gets it up top. Courtney Wolford on the dodge now. Looks inside. The ball's handled. But could not turn and face the... Not being able to turn and face the cage was Fonte. So now Ugen Fritz on the dodge. Tries to roll back right again. Nothing there. Here's Fonte. Looking inside. That one's knocked down again by Carpentier. She has had that pass nailed each time. Now Ween has it. Ween spins out. Tricky footwork there from the senior. She sprints in. Gets across the field to Holly. Holly looking inside. And Kirsten Hale unable to pull in the pass. It was a good idea. Now Lyons riding the Explorers towards the sideline. She's going to get the foul called on her. Now the Explorers with it again. Faye has it now. Looking inside. Now gets it back to Fonte. Fonte to the near side. Ilgen Fritz spins back in. He's going to take a shot. That one's saved by Carpentier. Carpentier having herself another nice evening. The sophomore with 4 saves, only allowing 2 goals. Wolford is backed out. And now play resumes. Ball comes up top. Burnett Looks inside. It's a good find. Faye, backhand shot and a goal. That was a pretty one. Had the stick on the wrong side of her body, but flipped it, went backhand. And the second goal from the senior. And it is now 9-3. Allie Burnett picking up her first point of the season with that assist. So another long offensive possession culminating in a goal for the Explorers. And now they just got to try to get it done on the defensive side. They want to get back in this game. Just over 17 minutes remaining in regulation. And now it'll be Burnett back to take the draw with Abram. Once again, fans, thank you for watching Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware women's lacrosse. I am Kyle Coulter. Delaware heads on the road to take on Rutgers on Friday, but they'll be back. Take on Canisius on March 5th, at home. And then Villanova on March 9th and Monmouth on March 12th. All three of those home games, all three will be right here on Hens All Access. That ball is rolling towards Becky Gosler's way. And she's able to pick it up, sprint through two defenders. And defender on her back. Wow. Almost a sixth sense there, able to duck out of it. Good communication from her teammates. Now Abram has it along the far side. Using those long lanes to pass a few defenders. Forces it down low. Lyons able to pull that one in. Lyons draws a double team, loses the ball. Let's see if the Explorers can clear. Laughlin and Cage. Slowly pacing up the field. It's been a hard man-to-man ride for Delaware. They've caused quite a few turnovers. And that is number 38, Kiara Lynch, the junior from Richboro, Pennsylvania. And now Heidelball and Faye battling on the far side. Ball goes out of play. They're going to say last touch by Faye. So Heidelball will get it in front of her own bench. Now Lyons with it. Looking to feed inside. To Tellis over to Holly. And Delaware will set up the offense. Holly sprints in. That'll be Ricky getting into the 8-meter, taking a shot. And that one sails past the cage. Ball goes out of play. Last touch by Lyons. And the Explorers will get it back as we approach the midway point of the second half. O'Donnell. Nice move to get past Jamie Schwartz. Using that speed, sprinting up the field, trying to clear it all by herself. Gets bumped. She goes down hard. It'll be a foul against Delaware. A total of 43 fouls committed by both teams this evening. 25 of them, Delaware. Wolford with it. Trying to get it by Detellis. She draws another foul. Wolford has to back up. Looks like Detellis has earned her second yellow card. So she will head off for 2 minutes. Explorers with a good opportunity to put one in the back of the net. They are down by six with 14 minutes and 30 seconds to go, but they are man up. Nogan Fritz looking inside. Now gets it behind. Fonte gets it up top. Nogan Fritz on the dodge again. Spins back inside. Looks. Burnett. Shot and it's in. Beautiful offense there from the Explorers. And after assisting on the previous goal, Burnett gets a G. And while man up, the Explorers capitalize. It is now 9-4. We take a look at it again there. And Burnett drops her stick emphatically. Gets a big hug from her teammates. The penalty is wiped off, and we are now back at even strength. That'll be Abram and Burnett back to take the draw. Delaware shifting some players around, making sure they have the right personnel on the wings. As you see, number 25, Emily Pollard, the senior from Merrimack, New Hampshire, taking a wing. And that one is picked up by Seplo. And another draw control for the Explorers. The Explorers electing to put an extra defender in on the draws. Now we get a check up high by Delaware. Explorers still with the ball. Ilgen Fritz sprinting in past Abram. 12-meter, 8-meter, shot! And that one's knocked before it can reach Carpentier. It was a dangerous move. They're from the junior from York, Pennsylvania. Explorers looking to inch closer into the 8-meter. The ball's knocked down. Fay. Looks like we're going to get a foul inside the 8-meter on Delaware. Explorers have scored the last two goals, and now they have a free shot. It will be Wolford taking it. Devin Heidelball is at goal line extended, so he'll have to come out and stop the break. Also, Ali Karwoski just to Wolford's left. Whistle blows. Wolford's in. Takes the shot. It's a bouncer, and it's saved. Carpentier up to the challenge. Now has five saves. And that Wolford check was no good. Karwoski has it now. Sprinting to the far sideline. Now turns it upfield. Long pass up to Aaron Ween, who snuck past the defenders. 12-meter, 8-meter, gets in, spins, wants a goal, takes the shot. It's knocked down and ends up in the stick of Lachlan. Aaron Ween feeling it a bit when she gets into the offensive end, but that time unable to capitalize. So now it's Lachlan's job to try to get the ball back into the Explorers' offensive hands, and that one's knocked down. It's a battle on the near side. Strang able to come up with it. Now Newby. Newby gets it checked out, but a foul there against Mackenzie Rafferty. Newby still with it. Protects her stick from Lyons. Newby leaves it off. That's Ilgen Fritz with it. Ilgen Fritz takes it inside. Dangerous move. She gets knocked down inside the 8-meter. And it looks like she has earned the Explorers yet another free shot from the top of the 8-meter. We'll see if she decides to go for goal. Looks like she will. There's a shot, and it's checked out. I believe Coley Rickey got there as Ogun Fritz was going for the shot. Good play there from the captain. LaSalle will maintain possession. We're under 12 minutes remaining in regulation. Explorers down by 5. Wolford gets it up top. Ogun Fritz swings it over to Seplo. LaSalle finishing their substitutions. Wolford comes out. And a Kelly comes back in. Here's Ogun Fritz. Working on Karwoski. Looks down low. Now the pass inside. It's knocked down by Kirsten Hale. Fighting to get the ground ball. And we're going to get a call there against Kirsten Hale. Aggressively going after that ground ball. Fonte. Ogun Fritz with it now. Spins back. Dumps it off to Faye. Faye drops it. The ball's picked up by Ricky. Ball's still bouncing around. The ref with the whistle to her mouth wanting to blow it, but she decides to let the play on, and Seplo is able to come up with the ground ball for the Explorers. Now inside to Faye. Faye turns, shot, and another save by Taylor Carpentier, the sophomore. 6 saves. And that a dangerous pass there from Ween into the middle. It's knocked down. And the Explorers come up with it again. Now approaching the 10-minute mark. Ogun Fritz, sensing the numbers were not on her side, decides to pull it out. And now Fonte has it behind the cage. Now just below goal line extended, it's Kelly. And the rest of her teammates urging her to hurry. Not a lot of time here left. Seplo to her right now, gets it up top. That'll be Ogun Fritz on the dodge. She gets it behind. Fonte looking to feed. Now Kelly has it. Looks top side, guarded tightly by Abrams. Spins back. Now Fonte with it again. Burnett, goal and assists tonight. Seplo with it now. She spins in right. Tries to get by Devin Heidelbaugh. Ogun Fritz with it. Splits to her right. Nice move. Takes the shot and it's in. My goodness, what a beautiful dodge. There from Allie Ogun Fritz, getting her second goal of the evening. 3 straight goals now for the Explorers. They are inching back. It is now 9-5, Delaware. And it's not only that they've scored 3 straight, they've also had the ball on their offensive side of the field for a vast majority of the last 10 minutes, I'd say. And now we're going to get a timeout. Or it looks like just both teams are going to, or the Explorers are going to meet in front of their own bench, not an official timeout. Delaware will make some necessary substitutions, and we will go back for the draw. Delaware 9, LaSalle 5. 8 minutes and 47 seconds remaining. You are watching Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware women's lacrosse. As we get set for this draw, just a reminder that a recap and broadcast archive of this game will be available on our YouTube channel at UD Blue Hens. You can also find out what our crew does behind the scenes to bring you these broadcasts and spotlights. Follow at Hens All Access on Twitter. Abram and Burnett. And now the music has stopped. And we are about to get away. 1 minute shy of 8 p.m. here in what has been a very long game. multiple stoppages in the first half, including an extended stick check before the game, pushed the start time back a bit. Hawley gets the draw control. Rafferty, a little pressure from behind, but she's able to shield away from it. And now the wind beginning to pick up. Which I'm sure is not making many of the fans or the players too happy. Also, I believe since Kara Tatelis did pick up her second yellow card, she will not be back in the game. Ricky able to keep that one down. Now Hawley sprints in, has some room, takes the shot, and it's saved. My goodness. Hawley had a wide open look at goal. I'm not sure which Explorer stick knocked it down, but they're fired up. And the Explorers now have the ball back. Lions coming in for a check, and it looks like she might get a yellow card. She knew it, too. A silly check there from the senior, who gave a little extra shove. We mentioned in the pregame some bad blood between these two teams. Rivalry going back only 5 years, but a lot of history in just those 5 years. Now we get a run down the middle of the field, and it's knocked out by Newby, who is trying to go for a goal and make this a three-goal game. But Delaware's defense able to stand tall. Now Gosler has it. Delaware still man down. Aaron Ween looks ahead to Hawley. It's going to be a two-on-one on the right side, but Hawley decides to pull it out wisely. Gosler has it up top. That'll be Ricky on the dodge, way up top. Just trying to run out this penalty. Still a minute left. And this not the worst thing for Delaware. Taking 2 minutes off this clock. They did it earlier in the game, but now with the time, a huge factor for the Explorers. They're electing not to double team, and there's a high pass, but they're going to get a foul there against the Explorers and Danielle Strang. Hawley sprints out of the double team. Now tosses it back. Still 25 seconds remaining in the penalty. Ricky. Hawley with it. Splits back to her right. Avoids a check. Jamie Schwartz. Back up top to Gosler. 5 seconds left in the penalty. And Delaware runs down another LaSalle man-up opportunity. Casey Lyons sprints back onto the field. And Kirsten Hale has it up top. She's got 2 goals, 5 in the last 2 games. Now Lyons has it, looks inside. Schwartz, a shot and a goal! Lyons had her back turned to Schwartz, but the two worked so well together, knew exactly where Schwartz was going to be, turned and fired. Schwartz finished for her second goal of the evening. And Delaware stops the 3-goal Explorer run and go back up by 5. And I wonder if LaSalle recognized that the penalty was up because they went out to double team again. And that left Lyons wide open and then led to Schwartz being wide open. And the shot and the goal. So it is now 10-5, 5 minutes and 17 seconds remaining in regulation. We will go back for another draw. Lions with 2 goals and 2 assists. Burnett and Abram. That ball goes up. It's a scrum for it in the middle of the field. Still bouncing around. No whistle is blown yet. And a beautiful ground ball there by Anna Kelly. She's done a real nice job on the wing. Kind of understatedly here this evening. She's now got 3 ground balls, three draw controls. The senior from Ellicott City, Maryland, did not start the game, but has gotten some considerable minutes and has made the most of them. So LaSalle still down by 5 with under 5 to go, and they have not been scoring quickly. All of their goals have come after long offensive sets, but they just don't have that luxury anymore. So we may see some forced passes in the middle, trying to get Caitlin Fay any kind of room in the 8-meter, or Ilgen Fritz to put the ball away. Here's Edwards trying to get top side. Heidelball on defense. Spins back to her left. Now back to her right. Draws a double team in the 8-meter. It's checked out and picked up by Abby Webel. Aaron Ween had the cause turnover. Now Aaron Ween standing wide open in the middle of the field. You don't want to cut. The schoolyard name for that would be cherry picking, but after Ween has caused a turnover, she sprints ahead and tries to force the fast break. Kirsten Hale now has it. Looks down low. That ball falls out of the stick of the Blue Hens, but we're going to get a call there against the Explorers. And now that will be Caroline Farley for a free position shot. Trying to get her first goal as a Blue Hen. Sprints in, shot, and it's in! Number 8. Gets her first goal as a Blue Hen. It comes with a free position shot, and how appropriate. Sweet Caroline plays over the PA system here at University of Delaware Stadium. So good for the freshman getting on the board and extends the Delaware lead back to 6. Abram and Burnett back to take another draw. That ball's lofted up, ends up in the stick of Gosler, who gets another draw control. That's a great sign for this Blue Hen squad that Abram and Ghost are working so well together on the draw. And now LaSalle, out of necessity, pulling the goalie and double teaming. Ricky has it now, goes far side. That's Rafferty with it. Now back behind, Schwartz has it. Looks into the crease. There's a shot, and it goes just wide from Gosler. The backup was there. Under 3 minutes to go. Look inside. Rafferty trying to get on the board, and she does. Slides it in the side. And Rafferty gets her first goal of the evening. Delaware now opens up a 7-goal lead. For Rafferty, that is her 2nd goal of the season. So after it looked like the Explorers could possibly get back in this game. Three straight goals, bringing it from 9-2 to 9-5. Delaware has brought the hammer down, and they're now back up by 7. Now we get some substitutions coming in. Some fresh faces on the field. I see number 22, Allie Cam, the sophomore from Severn, Maryland. Also number 34, Megan Santillari, the sophomore from Berwyn, Pennsylvania. She's on the wing on the near side. Ball's up. And it is picked up there by Farley. Good chance to see the future of Delaware lacrosse. Jamie Schwartz runs through a double team. Rafferty loses it, but is able to pick up the ground ball again. Call against the Explorers. Rafferty dumps it down low. Looking cross-crease, but it's knocked down there by O'Donnell. That was Farley on the feed, looking cross for Schwartz. That one, a long pass, intercepted by Coley Rickey. Rickey only 5'3", needed every inch of it to get up and get that one. And Sarah Comstock, the freshman from Raleigh, North Carolina, with it now. It's going to be a call against Delaware. And now a pass up. Fast break opportunity here for the Explorers. Sprinting in is Mary Abram to cut off that fast break. What hustle. Up by 7 with 1:30 left. The game essentially out of hand for the Explorers, and she still hustles in and stops an offensive chance for the Explorers. Great job there from the junior from Wilmington. There's Wolford getting topside, takes the shot, and it's in! Wolford gets one with 1:06 left. Wolford's first goal of the season. We'll see it again there. Able to beat Cam topside and turned and rifled it in. It is now 12-6, 66 ticks left on the game clock. So it'll be Abram Burnett once again. Delaware winning the draw control battle 13-6 so far this evening, with at least one more coming. That ball is slung to the right in front of the Delaware bench. And it's picked up along the far side, ground ball by Isabel Schmidt, the freshman from Malvern, Pennsylvania. And a call there against Delaware. Newby will end up with it. Comstock, Schmidt, and Rafferty on defense, but a nice sprint out there by Newby. Newby threads the needle up to Burnett. Burnett looking down low. There's a shot, and it's in! Katie Fonte goes top right. A beautiful feed there from Burnett, who has her second assist of the evening. Take another look at it there. No hesitation there from Fonte, who went top right. And with this young Delaware defense, little out of sorts there, but there's no better teacher than experience. So 43.8 reads the game clock. Now 12-7 Blue Hens. And Abram and Burnett back for another draw. That ball's up in the air, controlled and then lost by Comstock. So the Explorers have it and they try to launch it. But Aaron Ween is right there. Shannon Hawley comes up with it. Puts it ahead. There's Farley. Farley trying to outrun a double team. Spins inside. A call there against the Explorers. 23.9 seconds left. Farley gets it up to Rafferty. Rafferty to Comstock. Comstock down low to Schwartz. 10 seconds now remaining in the game. Schwartz, double teamed. Driven back towards the 30-yard line with 4.6 seconds. The whistle blows again. So Schwartz will most likely run out this game. And she tosses it up. And a check up around the head with 1.3 seconds left. And we will get a yellow card. A very unnecessary check there from the Explorers. Prolonging the end of this game. 1.3 seconds remaining. Abram has it now. Just waiting for the whistle to blow. And that will do it. Delaware takes down the LaSalle Explorers by the score of 12-7. They improve to 3-1. LaSalle drops to 0-2. A good offensive performance there from the Hens. Once again, another six players putting the ball in the back of the net. Eight players putting the ball in the back of the net. So another balanced scoring attack. And Delaware comes away with a great team win. That will do it for us here from Hens All Access. I'm Kyle Coulter. Until next time, have a great night, everybody.